are a unique department in that we're a combined anthropology and geography program. There are only a handful of others in the U.S. Our partnership that we have with Brookgreen Gardens is a great opportunity for students to learn while they're participating in hands-on original research.
It's focused on the archaeological digs for our slave sites. This partnership enables us to have accurate historical information about this property and really contribute to the overall knowledge of how Brookgreen and the rice plantations here and enslaved Africans lived, which will inform all of our exhibits and programs.
The students have the opportunity to not just learn about archaeology kind of in the abstract from reading listening to lectures or viewing videos or something, but they actually go out and participate in the actual process. You know, so they see from some of the research design portions to the execution in the field and how we do sampling, the record keeping in the field. They get to do some public interpretation.
It's actually really, really cool to actually be able to go to the plantation and get your hands kind of dirty, actually get into a unit and start digging with trowels and shovels and actually looking and taking care of the materials that we're looking to find.
It's a very different experience. It's very hands-on. Because in the classroom you may learn about all this, but you're not actually getting to do it. So when you walk out here and you actually get to pick up the trowel and like scrape up the dirt yourself and find the objects, it's almost more rewarding in a way because you're getting to do it yourself instead of just hear about what other people have found.
What we have here is the working area that we've gridded out for our May semester 2018 field school.
What we're trying to do is find potential remnants of the slave village that potentially was in this area. There was a map drawn up by one of the previous owners that shows generally where one might have been, but from the scale we can't really tell.
Dr. Palmer has decided to excavate this area because he believes through GPR and shovel testing that there is a potential structure here. A couple years ago they came out here and they excavated in similar areas. So a couple years later, now we're coming out here to see if there's any more post holes.
This semester we have opened up more 1x1 meter units to see if we can find more of what we call post molds, which is basically a stain that's left in the ground from the support beam of a structure. We're looking at the period of the Joshua John Ward era when the rice plantation really expanded, so 1830s to about the time of the Civil War. That was when the Brookgreen Rice Plantation was at its largest in terms of size. There were more than 1,100, you know, enslaved Africans. So we're trying to find what was the extent, you know, of the housing area for them. Once we find one structure that we can kind of confirm that that's what it was, then we can start measuring out from there and finding more. And then, you know, we can start relating the artifacts that we find to a particular household in some cases and start telling the story of the people who lived there.
It's a lot of hard work. You know, we were out here, like, first couple days was just clearing land. And then once we got through that, we're digging through, like, a bunch of roots and bugs, and it's all in the hot sun. It's a lot harder than I thought it'd be, but it's very rewarding, too. We're going there, we're using little trowels, but as we're doing that, we're finding objects, and we're, you know, marking and bagging those, and we have to sift all the dirt we go through. And just going through that, you never know what you're gonna find. So it's very cool. It's hard work, but it's worth it.
These are some of the artifacts that we're finding here at our site. So ceramic, cut nail, glass, tobacco pipe stem.
Something like this is very cool. I wasn't expecting it. I actually just found it while troweling, and that's why we do this instead of shovels. It's really interesting just to think about, you know, how this was used back, a couple hundred years ago, maybe. It's, you know, one of the reasons why we're here doing this. I think it's amazing. It's why I like archaeology. It's like a little, you never know what you're gonna find.
Nice thing about this class is most of the students are still gonna be following through on the project in the fall. and they'll be washing, identifying, cataloging, and starting to make sense out of what we're finding. So you can just measure what the height is going to be.
0.58
millimeters. We have the artifacts from each particular context bagged separately. And context is just a shorthand for the horizontal and vertical exact location of them. We use these for teaching, but also these are part of the research collection, and they'll be housed at Brookgreen Gardens. They're going to curate all these materials.
One of my ideal goals for this is to be able to find something that has some meaning for present-day Gullah, many of whom are descended from people who were enslaved right out here at Brookgreen.
We did find quite a few ceramics. We also found quite a few of the nails that are used for structure support, and we found those in relation to, or at least what we're hoping is in relation to the feature elements, which would be post-molds for where there could have been structures that used those specific nails to hold up buildings for as far as like the slave village areas go. Doing the lab afterwards is actually kind of unique because it's looking at Brookgreen as a whole and taking it as this is where I'm going to go and go dig, and then it's one of those where now we're actually looking at what this means to the property and what this actually can mean for the state and the history in general.